स्क्रीन इज विजिबल।
यस सर।
ओके ओके सो वी कैन स्टार्ट नाउ। गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर एनटीए लेक्चर नंबर 7। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडेज एजेंडा, टुडेज पॉइंट, व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट विद इन 2 मिनट्स वी कैन रिवाइज। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर we have discussed the only one topic, that is how to find out the equivalent resistance between two terminals of the given circuit or given network. So there are these some rules or some what we can say steps to find out the equivalent resistance between two terminals. So we have discussed in the previous lecture actually how to find out the equivalent resistance that we have discussed. Just wait. The screen is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the next one, how to identify whether the components or resistors we can consider, how the resistors are connected in the circuit, whether they are connected in series, whether they are connected in parallel. Okay. So that is the very important thing, because many students are failing to identify whether resistors are connected in parallel or series. Even though if you are not identified correctly, then you will get the wrong answer. That's why the first important step is you have to clearly observe the circuit, how the resistors are connected, that you have to find out, and in which direction you have to observe and in which direction you have to measure, that all rules you must know. Okay, so whenever you are observing from left to right and calculating, then you have to start from measuring from opposite side, that I already told. Okay, so whether the resistors are connected in series or parallel, we can identify by we have taken this example. Okay, when we solve some example, then and then we can get the theoretical part clearly. Now this example we have taken in the previous lecture, how the resistors are connected and they are asking to find out the resistance, equivalent resistance between terminal A and B. Now here you have to measure, or if you are considering the step one, measure from opposite direction, that I already told. So this will be the RAB you have to calculate, or you have to measure from left to right, but you have to start for measuring from opposite side. So 4 and 8, how they are connected? They are connected in series because same current will flow through this 4 and 8. That's why 4 and 8 will give the 12 ohm total. Then this 2 6 ohm resistors are connected exactly parallel to each other. So that will give 6 parallel with 6 gives the 3 ohm. Now 3 and 3 are connected in series, that will give the total 6. So 6 and 12 are in parallel. So that 12 and 6, whatever the parallel combination answer we can get, that will be in series with 2. And that will give the RAB. So how we are getting the RAB, that already we have discussed in the previous lecture. Okay. Now, okay, so the next one, after that, if you are observing, so total we have calculated like this, RAB is equal to 2 plus this final, I will write 6 parallel with 12. So that we have got calculated, and answer we got something that I will show that what is the exact answer we got. Okay, so if you are observing that one, so that we got 6 ohm. Okay, so 12 is in parallel with 6. 12 is in parallel with 6. That will give total what? 4 ohm, and that 4 is in series with this 2, and total answer of RAB, which you have calculated between A and B terminal, that will give the 6 ohm. So we have calculated this in the previous lecture. We have solved this one. And after that, we have solved 2 more examples. Okay. 2 more examples we have solved. Now we can move towards the today's point. That will be the types of sources. Now types of sources means what? Type of energy sources. The energy which is given to the other elements in the circuit. So other elements may be the electronic devices, electrical devices, or whatever it may be. Okay. So electronics devices, in that it may be linear, it may be non-linear. So we can discuss what is the linear, non-linear, what is the unilateral, bilateral. In the first unit, we can discuss in detail. But just remember that we are discussing now the prerequisite, in that we are going to discuss the types of sources. Again, this part we are understanding in detail in the unit number 1. In detail, we are learning in the unit number 1. But as a prerequisite part, we need to understand the sub basics of types of sources. So the energy sources are always active. The energy sources are always active, because what is the function of these energy sources? To give the energy, to give the current, to give the voltage, to give the power to the other elements which are present in the given network. So always remember, the energy sources are the active elements. Are you getting my point? Now example I will take myself as a teacher. I am giving the knowledge to you people. You are now in the class just listening. Okay. And after completion, you are asking some questions. That is another method. But what you are doing as a primary base, I am giving the knowledge to you people by taking lecture, by discussing with all these points, and you are listening, you are trying to understanding. Okay. So you are becoming now what you can say, passive element, and I am an active element. Are you getting my point? So energy sources will give the energy to the other elements of the circuit. Okay. So for that, what are the types of sources that we have to understand? And it is important, because in this subject, we are totally analyzing the different circuitry, different network, by using the different network theorems, by using the different circuit analysis method, then by using the different laws, okay, by using different mathematical concepts like Laplace transform we are using. We are using the linear differential equations. Are you getting my point? So all these concepts we require to understand to solve the network problems. Now, the types of sources we are going to start. So active elements. So active elements are the network elements which will deliver the power to the other elements present in electrical circuit. So active elements are also called as sources of voltage or current. I already told that it may be the voltage, it may be the current, it may be the power sources. But in this chapter or in this syllabus, we are not discussing about the power sources. We are focusing only on voltage sources and current sources. So we can classify the sources into two categories. One is the independent and another is the dependent. So anyone can tell what is the independent and what is the dependent? General meaning of independent and dependent. Anyone can tell what is the meaning of independent and dependent? Anyone? No one knows the independent and dependent? Yes or no? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is the meaning of independent and dependent? I am an independent person. I am a dependent person. What is the difference?
एखाद्यावर अवलंबून असणे किंवा म्हणजेच डिपेंडेंट आणि एखाद्यावर अवलंबून नसणे म्हणजेच इंडिपेंडेंट.
Yes, very good answer. Very good answer. Okay. So independent sources means what? Whose value does not depends on anything. Independent sources means what? Whose value does not depends on anything or on anyone. Are you getting my point? Next, dependent sources means what? The dependent sources means the sources whose value depends on some another thing, some another parameters in the circuit. Are you getting my point? So symbolically also they are different. Symbolically also they are different. We can easily identify whether the given source is of type independent or whether the given source type is of dependent. Okay, without looking the values, we can easily identify. How? Based on the symbol. Based on the symbol, we can easily find out. So how to find out whether the source is independent, whether the given source is dependent? There are the two methods. One is based on the actual value and another is based on the symbol. So I am referring the symbolically, we can easily and quickly identify it. Okay. Now next one. Well, we can start now the first point, that is the independent source. So independent source means what? As name suggests, the independent source produces the fixed values of voltage or current. And this does not depends on any other parameter. Means, suppose we are considering only here voltage and current source, but whose value does not depends on any other parameter in the circuit. So those sources are called as independent voltage source as well as independent current source. Okay. So independent voltage source is the one type, subtype, and another subtype is independent current source. Okay. So we can discuss the further points in detail. So independent voltage source and independent current source, how the symbolically we have to identify. So first of all, I will talk about independent voltage source. And here I will talk about independent current source. So So independent voltage source, there are the two symbols like this. Ek tar aso aso shukel. Okay. And the circle within that plus minus polarity. So this is called as what? Any one of these called as battery. This is called as symbol of battery or cell, which you are using in the remote control, in the wall, gadgets like the watches. Then the cells are used in many remote controls. The batteries we can use. Okay, so symbolically they are representing like this. The longer plate will be the positive, the shorter plate will be the negative. So this is the plus minus. Actually, this is the original symbol, the second one. But when we are connecting two batteries in series, the symbol is like this. When we are connecting three batteries, the symbol will be like this. Okay, it will increase one by one. How many batteries you are connecting in series? Okay, so this is the one. This is the one symbol. Just I will tell. So this is the first symbol of the voltage source, and this is the another source. That is, circle is there. Inside that, plus minus polarity will be there. So if you are observing any one of these symbol, then this is called as what? Independent voltage source. These are called as what? Independent voltage source. Ata hyacha value kay asnar aahe? Suppose this will be the 5 volt. Suppose this will be the 2 volt. So what is the meaning of this? The battery whose value will be 5 volt means it does not depends on any another parameter. Here also the voltage source is given along with polarity whose value is 2 volt. It will never change. It remains 2 volt. Okay, it remains 5 volt. If both are what you can say ideal sources, the value never change. It will remain same. So these are called as what? Ideal, or you can say independent voltage sources. Now, what will be the current source? How we can identify that whether the given source is current source? So that will be like this. A circle, within that arrow will be there. Already we have solved today one example, the fifth example. Okay, in that we have used the current division. So in that I have shown the one example, in that the source was there, that is of 1 ampere. So this will be suppose 1 ampere. So this will known as the independent current source. So if circle is there, straightforwardly you can consider as a independent sources, circle or battery. If there, then these sources are considered as a independent sources. Only you have to check whether arrow is there or whether polarity is there. If polarity is there, then it is voltage source. If arrow will be there, then it is considered as a current source. So any questions of the independent sources? Anyone having questions related to independent sources?
No, sir.
Okay. So everyone understood the types of sources in that independent sources? No questions? So that we can move towards the next point. Okay. Next here, how the graphically we have to represent whether the independent source is there or dependent source is there. Okay, or in that, once we identify the independent source is there, again there will be the two types. In independent, whether it is ideal source or whether it is practical source. Okay, so that we have to identify. Now, if you are considering this voltage source, Vs, whose value is Vs. Okay, once you are connecting this voltage source in the circuit, the voltage across which means if you are connecting resistor, any component, then the voltage across that component will be the same. That is the Vs. That will be the Vs one. Okay, now here the VS is shown and there is no internal resistance. Okay, if internal resistance is not there, means what? R is equal to zero. If no resistance will be there, then resistance value becomes zero. So if voltage source is there and no internal resistance, means this is considered as an ideal voltage source. Ideal voltage source. Okay. If you are plotting the graph current versus voltage, then it will remain same. It will remain constant. Whose value is Vs? Whose value does not change? It remains as a 5 volt. Suppose this Vs is a 10 volt, then it remains as a 10 volt. Okay, so this type of source is called as what? Ideal independent voltage source. Okay, and these are called as VI characteristics. VI characteristics or VI graph. Okay, now similarly, you have to observe for the current source. See here, this is called as what? Independent practical voltage source. So why it is called as practical voltage source? Anyone? We are talking about independent voltage source now in that two types, ideal and practical. So practical, we are now discussing. Ideally, we this remains constant. Okay, remains constant. Now, here, the practical source is given in that the resistance RS will be there. This resistance RS is called as what? Internal resistance of this VS. So actually this total symbol, this total representation is called as what? Practical voltage source. As it is VS, whose value is fixed, that's why it is called as independent practical voltage source. Okay, and VI characteristics are shown in this right hand side. So what is the difference between ideal voltage source and practical voltage source? Anyone can tell now with respect to this graph, with respect to this VI characteristics, what is the difference?
In ideal voltage, voltage is constant, but in practical, the voltage is decreases.
Yes. So here, for ideal case, the voltage remains constant. That is, Vs value never change. But here, for practical, it is in decreasing order. Okay, some value will. Means instead of 5, it will sometimes give the 4.8, 4.9 like this. So why it is happening? Why it is happening? Why it is decreasing?
Because of resistance.
Yes, yes. Very good answer. Because for practical sources, there is an internal resistance. So when the current I will flow through this path, okay, when the current I will flow through this path and it will flow through this RS, then across RS, some voltage will drop. So how to find out the voltage across this resistor? That is I into RS. By Ohm's law, we can find out I into RS. So that voltage will be minus from this supply voltage. And that will be available here. That is V is equal to Vs minus I into Rs. So that much of voltage is available. Actually, we are providing Vs, but actually giving the voltage across any component, that will be the V. So what is the difference between Vs and V? That will be the Vs minus I into Rs. Okay. So this will be the difference between ideal voltage source and practical voltage source. Are you getting my point, everyone? Because some voltage will drop across resistance RS. That's why whatever we are getting, So this voltage I will mark like this. This will be I into RS. So that voltage will get drop across this resistor RS. So I am finding out that what will be the voltage across A and B. So that will be the Vs minus I into RS. So graphically also there will be the slight change. So it will decrease because here some part is decreasing, some part is subtracting from the Vs value. Are you understand? So this is the graph of V. This is the graph of V here. Now the next one. Similarly, we can talk about the current source. So first of all, an independent current source produces a constant current that already we have seen along with symbol. This current is independent of the voltage across its terminal. Independent ideal current source and independent practical current source we are going to discuss now. So independent practical and current source, what will be the difference? It is the same as the independent voltage source. Only the symbolically it is different. Now here current source they are taken instead of voltage source. And this is the ideal current source, but it is of independent because the value is given and symbol is the circle. Okay. Now, what will be the current? I is equal to IS, means whatever the current is flowing through here, that will be the same of IS. If you are plotting the graph, V versus I, that is VI characteristics, it will give the constant current, that will be the IS value. Okay. So, VI characteristics of independent ideal current source is a constant line, which is always equal to the source current. Now next one, if we are considering the independent practical current source, so here this will be the practical current source. The current source symbol is there. This is independent because circle symbol is there whose value is IS, but resistor is now in parallel. This resistance is called as what? Internal resistance of current source. Okay, now you the question is coming in your mind. Why here parallel? Why it is parallel RS? In ideal current source, the RS is infinite. In ideal current source, the RS is infinite. But for practical, it is present. Okay, if it is minimum, then it is dangerous. We cannot pass the I to the next part. So it should have maximum value. RS should have maximum value for converting into practical into ideal current source. So for ideal case, the RS value will be the infinite. RS value will be the infinite for practical. Sorry, for ideal. Okay, now next one, if you are plotting the graph of VI characteristics here, it is somewhat decreasing. Why it is decreasing? Because of this resistance, some current will flow through this. And that current will be the V by RS, due to which the less current will flow through next path. That will be the I is equal to total current. This is the total current IS. So at this point, it is getting divided. Some current will flow through this resistor RS. That will be the V by RS. And remaining current will flow through next path. That will be the IS minus V divided by RS. Means whatever the current we are passing, that will getting decreasing. That's why this will be the I value. This is the graph of I. Are you getting my point? So in the practical current source, the value of resistance should be something. For ideal current source, the value of RS should be infinite. So, my infinite resistance, asal tar kaya meaning hai? If infinite resistance is there, then the meaning is that is the open circuit. That will be the open circuit. Whenever the resistance will be the infinite, we can tell that circuit is the open. Current open circuit mein current zero ho to. Okay. Now, next one. So, I will show the resistor, this one. So what should be the value of, what should be the value of resistance here? If it is ideal voltage source, it is 0 ohm. For ideal voltage source, the R is equal to 0. What is the meaning of R is equal to 0? If resistance is 0, what is the meaning? The meaning is that it is short circuited. If resistance is 0, then the meaning is that it is short. If resistance is infinite, the meaning is that it is open. Okay, this concept you can remember. This is required most of the time. If resistance is 0, म्हणजे इथं रेजिस्टन्स नाही आहे, सिरीज मध्ये कनेक्ट झालं, इथं रेजिस्टन्स झिरो आहे, आर इज इक्वल टू झिरो, मीन्स इट इज शॉर्ट सर्किटेड. इफ रेजिस्टन्स इज नॉट देअर इन द करंट सोर्स, मीन्स द इट इज ओपन, अँड ओपन मीन्स आर इज इक्वल टू इनफायनाइट फॉर द करंट सोर्स. हॅव यू अंडरस्टूड नाउ एव्हरीथिंग?
येस सर.
ओके, सो वी हॅव कवर्ड नाउ इंडिपेंडंट voltage source in that practical and ideal. Next we have covered independent current source, in that we have covered practical and ideal. So independent part is over, independent part we have completed. Okay, now next we can move towards the dependent sources. We can move towards the dependent sources. So dependent sources, already someone told that whose value will be depends on other parameter in the circuit. So dependent voltage sources are the sources whose value will be depends on some another parameter. Mag parameter manje kay, another parameter means what? Anyone knows? So parameter means either the voltage or current across any element, voltage across any element or current passing through any element. Based on that, the value of given voltage source will change. That's why it is called as dependent sources. Now dependent voltage sources we can discuss in. So in that, before that we can discuss this one. Okay, so control sources and dependent sources both are same. Control sources and dependent sources both meaning are same, name will be different but both are the same. Okay, so as the name suggests, the dependent sources produce the amount of voltage or current that is dependent on some another voltage or current in the circuit. Dependent sources can be further classified into two parts. The first one is dependent voltage sources and second one is dependent current sources. So how to identify? So I will tell, dependent means whenever you are observing the symbol like diamond means chaukat. Okay, so whenever you are observing the diamond shaped symbol in the circuit, this is called as what? Dependent source. मग क्वेश्चन येतो, हा वोल्टेज सोर्स आहे का करंट सोर्स आहे, डिपेंडंट वोल्टेज सोर्स आहे का डिपेंडंट करंट सोर्स आहे. सो दॅट वी कॅन डिसाइड बाय पोलॅरिटी अँड एरो. सपोज इट इज पोलॅरिटी प्लस मायनस, देन इट इज डिपेंडंट वोल्टेज सोर्स. ओके, इफ द सिम्बॉल इज लाईक दिस डायमंड शेप अँड एरो विल बी देअर लाईक दिस, इट मे बी अपवर्ड, इट मे बी डाउनवर्ड, इट मे बी लेफ्ट टू राईट ऑर राईट टू लेफ्ट. इफ एरो विल बी देअर, देन दॅट विल बी द डिपेंडंट current source. So if diamond shape will be there, 100% you can see that, you can tell that this is the dependent source. But if polarity is there plus minus, then it is dependent voltage source. If arrow will be there, then it will be the dependent current source. Now clear symbolically how to identify?
Yes sir.
Okay, whenever the circle will be there, that will be the independent. Whenever the diamond will be there, that will be the dependent. And battery symbol, you know that, the plus minus, that is called as independent. Now we can discuss the dependent voltage source and dependent current source in detail. Now dependent voltage source, we can start the first of all. In the dependent voltage source, whose values will be depends on some another voltage or current in the circuit. This is very important. It depends on some another voltage or current in the circuit. Okay, based on that, there are the sub two types. This is the A point. This will be the B point. A type means what? Voltage dependent voltage source. As we are discussing about voltage source. Okay, so the voltage source, dependent voltage source, whose value depends on the voltage that is called as voltage dependent voltage source. In short, it is called as VDVS, voltage dependent voltage source. Now next, as we are discussing the dependent voltage source, but whose value depends on the current? Whose value depends on the current? That's why it is called as current dependent voltage source, CDVS. Are you getting my point? So dependent voltage sources are represented with sign polarity plus and minus inside the diamond shape. Already I told. Okay. The magnitude of voltage source can be represented outside the diamond shape. Now we can, I will show the symbol of voltage dependent voltage source and current dependent voltage source. Okay. So this is the first of all. I will draw the dependent voltage source. This is the plus minus. This is the plus minus. Okay. Now both are the dependent voltage source. Okay. Both are the dependent voltage source because diamond shape is there and insert that plus minus polarity is there. Now next, first of all, I am discussing the A, that is the voltage dependent voltage source, means K1 into V1. K1 into V1. Or you can just simply take the K. Okay. So K into V1. So this will be the value of this voltage source. Similarly, K into I2, suppose. So what is the meaning of this one? So this is the B1. That is the current dependent voltage source, and A will be the voltage dependent voltage source. Now, if you are observing, K will be the any constant value. It may be 1.1, it may be 2, it may be 3, it may be 100, it may be 0.5, anything. It will be the value K. Okay. V1 means what? V1 is the voltage across some branch, or it may be the voltage across some element in the circuit. In the circuit, V1 will be the any voltage. Okay. Mag to voltage change ala, V1 change ala, ki as a value change ala. K into V1, if you are putting V1 is equal to 2, suppose K is equal to 2, eh? That is a fix. Suppose you are taking V1 is equal to 2 volt. So what will be the value total? 2 into 2 becomes 4. So if V1 is 2.5, V1's value 2.5 ala. तर याचा या व्होल्टेज सोर्स व्हॅल्यू किती होणार 2 into 2.5 दैट विल गिव्स द 5 व्होल्ट आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट सो बेस्ड ऑन द v1 व्हॅल्यू द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ दिस डिपेंडेंट व्होल्टेज सोर्स विल चेंज आर गेटिंग माय पॉइंट सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट व्होल्टेज डिपेंडेंट व्होल्टेज सोर्स सिमिलरली द सेकंड वन इट इज कॉल्ड एज करंट डिपेंडेंट व्होल्टेज सोर्स बिकॉज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ दिस व्होल्टेज सोर्स डिपेंड्स ऑन दिस करंट व्हॅल्यू मग i2 म्हणजे काय व्हाट इज i2 सो i2 मीन्स the current flowing through some branch, current flowing through some element in the circuit. It may be any element. Are you getting my point? So based on that I2 value, the value of this given voltage source will change. Are you getting my point? So this is what voltage dependent voltage source and current dependent voltage source. Everyone understood now? Dependent voltage sources. If any questions will be there, you can ask freely. Don't hesitate. Okay, now we can move towards the next type, that is the dependent current source. Okay, now dependent current source, again the same. A dependent current source produces the current, but amount of this current is depends upon some another voltage or current in the circuit. Now there are the further two classification, voltage dependent current source, as it is current source, it may be depends on voltage, it may be depends on current. Based on there are the two subtypes. Voltage dependent current source, that is called as VDCS. And next one, current dependent current source, that is called as CDCS. Okay, voltage dependent current source and current dependent current source. Now the dependent current sources are represented by with an arrow inside a diamond shape. So already I told the symbol. So this will be the symbol, that is a diamond shape. If arrow will be there like this, it may be any direction, upward, downward, left to right, asa pan asu shakto. How you are connecting depends on that. Okay, it is from right to left. It may be like this. It may be like this. So these are the four possibility, okay, of the symbol. So the arrow indicates what? The direction of current flow. The arrow indicates what? The direction of current flow. Okay. Now we can take anyone here. We can take anyone. So the first one, A point, I will take this as a A point. That is the voltage dependent current source. And this will be the B point. That is the current dependent current source. So A, consider voltage dependent current source. So first of all, we can draw the current source symbol. Next, arrow you can take like this upward. Now this is the current source because arrow is there and diamond shape is there. That's why it is dependent current source. Now, whether it is depends on voltage or whether it is depends on current, based on that, there will be the classification. So first of all, voltage dependent I will take. So K into V2. K into V2 means K is the constant. It may be float. It may be. किंवा डेसिमल पॉइंट म्हणू शकतो किंवा पूर्ण संख्या म्हणू शकतो व्हॉट एव्हर इट मे बी द के व्हॅल्यू विल बी द सम कॉन्स्टंट व्हॅल्यू वी टू इज नथिंग बट व्हॉट वोल्टेज अक्रॉस सम इलेमेंट और वोल्टेज अक्रॉस सम इलेमेंट और सम ब्रांच इन द गिवन सर्किट इफ दैट वोल्टेज विल चेंज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ दिस करंट सोर्स विल चेंज सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज व्हॉट वोल्टेज डिपेंडंट करंट सोर्स VDCS ओके द नेक्स्ट बी पॉइंट बी सिम्बॉल सपोज दिस विल बी द लाइक दिस The arrow is like this. Okay. Now here the value of this dependent current source will be K into IN. Suppose like this. So K is the constant value and IN is the current flowing through any branch, flowing through any element in the circuit. If IN will change, the value of this dependent current source will change. So this is called as what? CDCS. Current dependent current source. So total there are four dependent sources will be there. So anyone tell what are these four? First one. Anyone can tell now?
Voltage dependent voltage source.
Yes.
Current dependent voltage source.
Yes.
Then voltage dependent current source and current dependent current source.
Yes, very good. 100% correct. Okay. So if once you identify these types of sources, then some part of analysis becomes easy. Because without observing, without understanding the diagram or the network, we cannot start which thing we have to apply, how to apply, what to calculate. So first is observation. Observation is important. Okay. So I am drawing here all four symbols. So first of all, I will draw the dependent voltage source plus minus. Next, dependent current source I will draw. So this is the summary. So this will consider, suppose voltage dependent voltage source VDVS. Next, CDVS, current dependent voltage source. Next, VDCS, voltage dependent current source. And last one is CDCS, that is a current dependent current source. Okay. Now voltage source and current source I draw, but on which thing it is depends. That's why it is K into V1. This will be K into I1. This is K into V1, kima V2 kya, and this will be K into I2. Are you understand? So these are the summary of dependent sources, types of dependent sources, VDVS, CDVS, VDCS, and CDCS. Diamond shape this la ki dependent. Okay, circle this la ki independent. And battery. Battery is also considered as a independent. Okay. So it is easy to understand or guess or identify which is the symbol and what is the type of sources. So next will be the source transformation. Okay, source transformation we can discuss and then we can stop. There will be the chances of conversion from practical voltage source into practical current source. There will be, we can easily convert the practical voltage source into practical current source. Practical voltage source is shown in this figure, means Vs is in series with Rs, that can be converted into practical current source, which is shown in the right hand side. So Vs and Rs is converted into Is and Rs, means Rs will remain same, value will not change, but position will change. Here it is in series, here it becomes in parallel. But how to find out Is if you know the Vs and Rs? So Is is find out by using Ohm's law. Is is equal to this voltage Vs divided by Rs. Okay. If I want to convert this practical voltage source into practical current source, first of all, change the diagram. And next, Rs here, series there, you can connect in parallel, value will be the same. And Is value will be calculated Vs by Rs, means Vs this value and Rs this value. Vs by Rs, if you are doing, you can get the Is value. So this is the source transformation, that is practical voltage source is converted into practical current source. Now similarly, you can convert the reverse. So practical current source will be there. So you can convert into practical voltage source. So this will be the practical current source. Is and Rs is given. If you want to convert into practical voltage source, then Rs position will change, resistance position will change. Here it is parallel, you can connect in series. And Vs you have to draw, that is the plus minus polarity you have to show. But how to find out Vs? Vs you can find out, Vs is equal to Is into Rs, that is by Ohm's law. Vs is equal to I into R, that is Is into Rs. This is by Ohm's law, you can find out the answer of this Vs. So you can easily find out, easily convert one form of source into another form of source. That is the, both are convertible. Practical voltage source into practical current source and vice versa. Okay. So the last point is remaining. That will be the star delta transformation. So this is the star delta transformation. Whether you learn in the BEEE subject, star delta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is also required for GATE exam. So this is the star delta transformation. Rarely we required for our subject. So this will be the delta network where are the three resistors have connected, RAB, RAC and RBC. And this will be the Y. Y means WYE, or it is also called a star. Star network. So star delta kiwa y delta doni meaning mantat tela. So in the star network, RA, RB and RC are connected. Okay, so if delta is given, how to convert into y, that is given here formulas. To convert a delta network into y network, the formula is RA is equal to, means if you are finding this one, RA is equal to RAB into RAC. So symbolically like this. So inside that I will draw, suppose this will be the RA, this will be the RC, this will be the RB. So RA you can calculate like this. RA means what? At A point which two resistors are connected, RAC and RAB, that you can take the product in the numerator, RAB into RAC. Now next, in the denominator part, you have to take the addition of all these delta elements, that is RAB plus RAC plus RABC. When the addition gets in the denominator. Similarly for RB, when you are finding RB, at B point which two resistors are connected, RBC and RAB, that you can take in the numerator multiplication. Denominator will be the same. Similarly, RC you can find out RAC into RBC divided by addition of all resistors. Okay, so this is what delta to star conversion. Now in the delta to star conversion, what is the common thing? The denominator is the same, that is addition of all resistors of delta network, that is the denominator same. So next will be the star to delta, means star network is given and if you want to convert to delta. Okay, so RAB you have to find out, that is the this one RAB, RBC that is this one, next RAC you have to find out. So here the numerator will be the same, that is the sum of product of two resistors, RA into RB plus RA into RC plus RB into RC. So sum of product, it is called as what? Sum of product. Okay, SOP mantha apan tumhala digital technique madhe hoil te concept, sum of product. Sum means addition, product means product, don element cha product chi addition. Here all three numerator you are observing, numerator mante that is the same, only denominator will change. RAB find out karaycha asel tar RAB, RAB cha samor kutla RCA, that is the in the denominator. Kiwa RAB madhe kutla missing hai, RAB madhe kutla missing hai word letter C missing hai manun to RC. Ita RBC manlar ita kutla missing hai, A missing hai manje RA. Ita RAC madhe B missing hai manje RB. In this way you can logically remember the formula. Once you can remember the formula, you can easily find out the answer, or you can easily do the star to delta or delta to star conversion. So this is we have covered today. So what we covered today, we have covered the types of sources, that is the independent sources and dependent sources, and after that practical voltage source into practical current source conversion and vice versa. And lastly we have discussed about star to delta conversion or and delta to star conversion. Okay, so in the next lecture we can start the nodal analysis we can start. So these are the prerequisite for the subject we have covered. We have finished the prerequisite of subject. Now next lecture onwards I will start the prerequisite for unit number 1. Ata unit number 1 la kay lagnar ahe prerequisite, that we are going to start in the next lecture. So any questions you have? Any questions?
No sir.
Okay, now we can stop. Thank you everyone.